the respect.
I just had a little bit of a question.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. And I hope everyone's had a good break and pretty soon to start again now. The autumn's with it. Well, not a bit yet, but the autumn astronomically. So I think we have some apologies for absence.
Kim Cooper, Tony Felbeck, Laxton, Norman, Holiday.
Right. Brian just had a word with me. He's popped out to get his other laptop, so he will be back in a minute or two. We'll explain that and start meeting on time at 1:15. Public participation time. I suppose we still need to go through this procedure of suspending the standing order. So are you all, first of all, does anyone wish to speak? Do we have any declarations of interest?
I do. On item 95, we discussed being outside the spa, the fact that my wife and son both work there, so I'm going to make that known.
Right, okay. Right, are there any other declarations?
I'm not sure if this is necessarily quite so related, but one of the plumbing applications, S2286, 16OL, which is for planning permission land on Common Lane.
Yes.
Due to how that might impact traffic and might not be on Common Lane, so I don't know if that's
going to be a question. I mean, unless your mother's property immediately abuts the site.
No, but I mentioned it rather than.
Yes, okay, no. As I said, you really have to be very close indeed for which of the torture is
issue with the rest.
So thanks for mentioning that.
I think it's helpful to record it in the minutes.
Yes.
In public.
Yes. Yeah.
People that have to abstain.
Yeah. Right. So, agenda item 86, which are the minutes of the meetings of the 12th of July and 26th of July. So, starting off on the 12th of July, I'll go through item by item, page by page as usual. So, page 72. Page 73, paragraph 52-53, over page 74, page 54.
Can we slow down a bit, please? I have done a fast reading course, but
no.
I'm there.
55, over page to 75, 56. 57, 58, 59, over the page to 76, 60, 61, 62, over the page, page 77, 63, 64, 65, 66, 67, 68 and 69. Are you happy going to sign those and that record of that meeting?
Yeah.
Proposed and seconded. And everyone's agreed with you. Okay. 26th of July, page 79, agenda item 73, 74, 75, 76, 77, 78, 79, 80, 81, and 82. Is everyone happy for me to sign those records? I will propose in a second, please. Proposed by me and then seconded by the other. Is everyone? Right, no matters arising from those that aren't on the agenda. So the Planning and Environment Committee, page 1, agenda item 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, over page 2. Over page 3, 6, 7, 8, 9, over page, and there's a perfect list of issues there, which I won't go through individually, but members of various comments on if they wish. Is everyone happy with those minutes? Director, I would propose it. Good. And a seconder. Okay. So Ron, planning applications associated matters. Are we going to try and show these?
Yeah.
Yep.
Okay. I think we've actually got that set up here.
Thank you.
That one's over like days as well, isn't it? So it's all at the same time. The first item of this agenda is a numbered S-2072-16FL. And it's an enlargement of the system wing of the windows on the southern elevation, installation of a fire door on the southern elevation, replacements of existing elevation, shutter doors on this elevation, southern dark old glass windows at Painting High Street.
This is the former woodland
cottage. It is woodland, yes, sir. Yes, it's all of those. I mean,
I'll make a couple of comments if you like. It is the former Woodhead Publishing. It looks like what's proposed will improve the site. The main issue seemed to be whether there was any negative impact on the Grade 2 listed building next door. So I don't know whether anyone thinks there is any impact.
It's restoring windows that were formerly there, like, isn't it?
No, I think it is, actually.
Yes.
So they're all locked up. Yes.
It looks like it would improve the site, and it talks about the little passageway.
I must admit, there's nothing that leapt out but me on this, actually. So would somebody like to make a proposal?
Would you like me to propose?
Yes, actually,
supported?
As chair of the planning committee,
So two that you're signing. Who else didn't vote? Anyone against?
I'm hand up.
You're about to my hand.
Right, so the second item is on S-213316FL, which is the erection of first board timber fence to front guard along the gate of 24 standing room close.
What's the height of the fence?
That's it, that's been honest.
1.5 metres, I think,
well,
or less than.
Yeah. So,
Sorry, just to make a further comment, and I did notice there was something in the correspondence about it being over 1 metre in height, and therefore will have an impact on the front, because it's around the front garden.
It is, yes. Well, that's why they're having to apply for permission, because the 1.5 metres we were within for this development, if it were not on the frontage.
Yes.
Have any of the properties either side got these fences?
No, they've got little, I'll bring it to them in a minute, but they've got little short single bar fences around, so presumably he wants to enclose his own garden.
Yes.
So a dog could run around, for example.
Don't reasonably know what he knows for this.
Well, I mean, yes, I mean, you have to decide whether it's acceptable in planning terms, really. Yeah. So, I mean, I
let me just bring up that.
Yes, there is a reason given. I don't know whether it's admissible to say what it is.
Well, he wants to enclose his garden, or her garden, I think it's a lady.
And I don't know why.
Why not?
He's still got high, considering
the. But that's the existing frontage.
So 1.5 metres is about the maximum height, isn't it?
So there you go. There's the existing, and there's the height. So it's the existing one to the side is high, and that's 1.5.
Yes. 4.5 feet,
isn't it?
Yes.
There is a fence further down. There's a fence which I think goes along the back of the other houses. If you, I don't know if you can sort of swing it around with that, but yeah, towards the right, I think there's a fence.
All the houses have that.
Yeah, so that's the front garden. Yes. I think just through there, you can see. I think there is a fencing there. Yeah.
There's other streets and sorts. Sorry, Jim.
The concerns I have with it is the impact on street scenes. It's generally a very open area.
Yes.
And I do have concerns about that. You know, you have one, so then
the one
fire, everyone's going to have it. And it's going to make that look a little bit dark. And
I'll propose we do not support.
And your reason would be the effect on the street scene.
Effect on the street scene.
Because you don't have to give a reason why the planning can't
happen.
No.
If this was approved, what would stop anybody else applying?
Yeah,
and then you change the whole field.
Well, I'm just saying, the characteristic street scenes to urban form of sorts basically, it's basically open front gardens.
Yeah. Right, so that's a do not support. So, for all? Not supporting.
They're not supporting.
Yeah.
Do not support.
I think for clarity, it would be easier if I was to take a vote on support, not on this one, because it's been proposed and seconded, but in future, in order to avoid the double negative, I think it's easier to approve.
Right, but at the end of the day, I've got 11 and there's 12 of you, so someone I've got.
Right, can we vote again? Sorry. So those who wish not to approve this application.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Got that.
Right. Those who wish to approve it, please indicate.
1, 2.
And those who wish to abstain. Right, so S2207 16FL, change of route design from the approved application 1619. Comments?
This is the orangery
at yes, it is,
13 yes. Queensway, yes. And I couldn't quite see from
what the difference,
the information what the difference was. I don't know whether anyone can enlighten me.
No, I couldn't either.
Do you have the revised plans?
Yeah, well, yes. I think the. I think
that was the existing plan, and they're talking about reverting to the original plan, aren't they?
Which?
It was very confusing.
It's the orange tree, or the conservatory.
It is, yes.
It's called an orange
tree. I mean, orangery was originally a large conservatory through oranges, yeah? Mm. So that's right, it would fly. Well,
yeah.
Well, I think it's absolutely minimal, actually.
So is it going to impact on anybody else?
I don't really think so.
And we did support it on the last occasion.
But it's already been done.
Yes.
I propose we support it.
Yes. Yes. I'll second that.
Well, done,
okay. So those who wish to support this application, please indicate.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Those who wish to oppose it, please indicate. Sorry, did you?
No,
did
he
you
hasn't done.
No, I'm not
abstaining. Okay. Abstentions?
2.
2.
2.12. Yes, done. Thank you.
Okay. 2132 16FL, front porch to terrace property and single story rear extension of pitch roof 49 Edinburgh Avenue.
I
get
that.
Okay.
So we're all queued up, ready to go.
Until
Microsoft got involved.
Yeah.
Okay, so this is a row of relatively underlying terraced houses, and
yes.
It's a relatively, those plans and elevations, would be nice if it was consistent. Okay, so on the left we see a new porch, which is relatively substantive, and quite an extension on the back of the kitchen and dining room.
Yes.
I'll bring up a street scene in the second for you. It's the second of a row of terraced properties. I know, I was very fast earlier on when they were all ready. There we go. So that's the it's the second one along there. So the porch would be significantly different to the rest, obviously, and then the back's rather excluded. So, but I guess it's a question whether the neighbours complain or not, and that's not really our issue, is it?
And the porch comes out how far again? It's quite
a large space.
Yeah.
Yes, it's 2.4 metres.
It's all through that street. So
yeah.
I'm going to propose do not support.
It's having a loo in it as well, though.
Yes, yeah. Don't forget there are two elements to this. This is a rear extension as well.
Yeah. And substantial.
Are there many other rear extensions on the?
I'll bring the block plan because I think no is the answer. There's the block plan,
and
there's nothing showing on that. Certainly in the five that are shown there.
It is the whole width of the building.
The neighbours were only notified on the 1st of September.
That's 12 days ago, isn't
it? Get 21 days to this. They could well have commented on it. It is quite substantial and will impact on the front street scene. Trouble is, if you look up all around Sawston and look at other rows of terraced houses where people have built porches, it does change the look of it. Once one appears, you will get others. It depends whether...
There can be an issue. It depends on the orientation, which I think is east-facing-east-west, if I'm not situated around here, can result if two neighbours have it down a small terrace frontage. You can create almost a cave-like effect on the downstairs window, on the downstairs front window.
Yes. Yeah. Yes.
Because I have seen examples of that in the...
Are we going to take this on two as one or two separate items? Because we've got two things going.
Well, I think yes. I think you'd be
You mean the porch and the rear extension?
Yeah. Yes. Yeah.
Well, they're both relatively disproportionate to the size of the house, aren't they?
And they're both part of the same application.
Yes. I mean, it's a single number, so you have to deal with it as a whole. It's a whole unit.
Right.
Yeah.
So we say we do not support.
Right, do not support what impact, or, well, large porch impact on the streets, and yeah, what about the back?
It would be overshadowing if you want to use that. I've got to point out it is single story, it is a pitched roof.
I've got overshadowing on there, single story.
Yeah.
Yeah. Right, so Neil, you seconded it, yeah? Okay.
Right, so those who do not support this application, please indicate.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Those who wish to support this application, please indicate.
1.
No. Those who wish to abstain.
Hold on, I'm looking.
Two, three votes.
It works.
It's going to be now. Two-story side extension, front dormer and porch at 3 Bayburn Road, S2242/16FL.
Two-story side extension. It's numbers. What number? Bedroom road from
three.
So it's a small bungalow at the moment. I'll pull up the and it's. Let me just give you the street view because that will show you its context.
Is that
one
that's just been sold?
That's the one there.
Yes.
And so they're talking about doing a significant upgrade. But I think relevant is the house next door. Well, that's a very similar frontage. Yes. We're obviously looking at trying to keep in the style. And that one at the adjacent has also been extended, as we can see at the back. So
that's relevant.
Yes, but I mean there is quite a variety of that section of Bedroom Road, yes.
Yeah, there's all mine. Just want to look further along.
So I think it would be
That's ready to be extended into five bedroom detached house.
I mean most of them are two stories actually, so.
Yeah. So and there's the two new ones along sort of the end, aren't they? One A and one B.
Yes.
Two A and two B.
Can we have the floor plan just to see what it would look like?
So
basically, they're creating a loft extension for those who just show up on the...
Yeah, the dorm windows. So. And an extension at the side, replacing the carriage.
Mm-hmm. remind you that the two two-storey ones on the corner did actually get permission for a dormer in the roof, which I misuse at the back, but it is visible from Cairns Road.
Yeah. So yeah, we've got two-storey properties adjacent to.
There's still be parking on the front,
isn't there? It's well set back, actually, yes.
Yeah, I don't think there's any impact on that. Yeah. What's your good plan?
Propose we support. Okay, so I'm a seconder.
Yep.
Right, so those who wish to support this application, please indicate. Abstentions. One, two, and two no votes. So finally, the big one, which is in one. 12 dwellings will be familiar with the site. And the bear in mind is an outline application, so the site plan you're showing is purely illustrative and could be changed.
Mr. Chairman, I noticed when I was doing this earlier that the in the documentation there are two different versions of the plan, one showing 12 houses. Which are relatively, some of them larger, and then a second part of the plan, I'll pull it up in a minute, that shows that, so there's one with 12 and one with 13. One with 13 has three houses, I think, of 50 square metres, so single bedroom houses. So the variety of houses in the 13 bedroom is significantly different. To the other one. So
I think I understand why that was done, because we'll be seeking the affordable housing element of this, and there is a demand for one bedroom for the units throughout the district.
I'm going to raise this issue of affordable housing, which I assume in this context means housing that is affordable to buy,
That's not the definition of affordable housing.
Okay.
Affordable housing is housing which is which attracts some form of subsidy. So social rented would be this sort of traditional form. There are also sort of intermediate forms, such as equity share, which is also comes under the category of affordable housing. So basically, on a site like this, you'll be looking at first of all, affordable housing split between social rented and equity share. And so the split that is normally done, it's 70-30.
70-30, I think.
In favour of social rented, but this, obviously those proportions don't really work on a site this size. So.
But it was the reason I'm mentioning it is there were clearly two different, substantively different versions of the plan.
But that's only an outline, so it's only illustrative.
Yeah, sure. But the difference in terms of affordable housing or variants of housing units, so one bedroom, 50 square metres, compared with the smallest on this is 75 square metres, I think.
Yes. I think that's a good point, but the application for us is for 12.
Up to 12.
Yeah. Only concern is partner responsible enough that one of the illustrative plans supplied.
I think it's worth commenting on that, but as I say, the application for us is up to 12.
Who are they going to build these then? Because when they build wineries, they have to build them 4 foot off the ground.
They do these, yes.
And they've got to do the same with that.
I think that's
they observed it on a floodplain.
Done?
And
As in the floodplain, they mentioned that.
So well, there is another one. There was a 47-page flood assessment, but the problem that we have with the floodplain sourcing is that the Environment Agency changes criteria about, it must have been about 2 or 3 years ago,
yeah.
And the floodplain planning is much tighter than certainly the floodplain that was used to inform the local plan that was drawn up, which is why some of these sites and that, you know, which were rejected in the local plan for flooding reasons are now coming back in again.
So here we see the balancing pond at the end, which is the otherwise empty that would notionally take potential overflows of water
I think that's an important qualification of the maps which the Environment Agency published, which relate solely to river and sea flooding. Obviously sea flooding is not relevant here, but a lot of the flooding issues in habit source is subservient to water runoff rather than flooding directly from the river. And the Environment Agency maps don't pick that up. So that is a valid point.
No,
I'm
not sure. I haven't seen Chris in traffic down there.
Yeah,
absolutely. And turning out onto High Street.
Yeah, but you know, there's 12 houses there, roughest, 24 cars past. You can't get down that road. It's down that end of Common Lane.
Mm.
You cannot get down there some days. You get butlers there, get lorries, apart from the road to unload. You've got the riding school, half the lane.
Mm.
And you've got the farm at the bottom, up and down there all the time. And that's, you know, you just can't
live
the houses,
doesn't
it? It's a big concern
of
the traffic.
I mean, you're probably talking on the basis of work that's done by the County Council in 2001, the issue by the County Council done by Atkins. I think they reckoned the standard traffic generation. I mean, obviously this varies from site to site. There's only a little part of it. There's about 3.9 per day. So for something this size, you'll be looking at between 40 and 50 extra traffic movements in Common Lane a day.
There is some data in reports about traffic movements early morning and in the evening.
Yeah. But the traffic generation things are obviously only very ballpark. It depends on the type of housing and who occupies. So I mean, you're a four-bedroom house with two teenage children, you'll probably have four.
But a road as wide, let's say, as Baker Road, they take that. The Common Lane.
Well, I think the problem. The problem is the junction with
the high street, and I've been touring the daily booklets, but I'm not sure I see the problem with extra traffic except at the junction.
It's just difficult
access out at that point.
I mean, I think on around up to about 50 traffic movements a day, I think we'd have difficulty in sustaining your GPS on those grounds.
Yeah.
Mm. But presumably it's something that
I see no problem in attracting attention to the problems at that junction.
Yeah, I think
that's
true. That's the issue.
It's one issue, isn't it? Because the critical issue for the country, the region, the district, the village, is lack of housing. So in that context, and while we're waiting for the local plan to be adopted or revised and adopted, whatever happens with that, the only thing that we've got is these opportunistic developments coming forward.
I think we need reassurance that the technical solution to water runoff and accumulation was adequate.
I mean, that's, I mean, there is usually a technical solution to a technical problem. It depends on whether it's within viability. I take your point entirely, because in terms of sustainability and proximity to village facilities, this site is actually much more sustainable than the ones that have been proposed in the local plan.
Yeah.
There's another thing about that site, the pump station at the bottom there.
Yes.
The tank is sitting at the top of Common Lane, now in Common Lane, now where the entrance is going to be. Wait to reverse down there to empty that sewage out when it all bums up. And that, it bums up three or four times a year.
That is a not uncommon problem around district pumping stations.
And that is, they're down there three or four times a year. It's actually got so bad, it's pumped up in Common Lane, and actually all the butler's yard is covered in sewer.
Nice.
The 68 was all covered in sewer with the gardens and that.
I've seen the cover lifted up by about 7-8 foot under the pressure of sewage coming out of this.
Yes.
You know, it's not going to...
And that's covered.
You can't really build no more houses down there. It's going to be murder for people.
Well, I mean, the flood report admits that there is a high water table down there, if you recall. I mean, obviously, they claim they have a technical solution to that.
Yes.
I mean, I think that would need to be very rigorously tested.
Well, I'm going back a few years, you have to go all that deep and you'll be on water.
Oh, yeah.
And it gets like that now sometimes in the winter.
Well, yes, I mean,
that land's been built up.
Regularly, you have standing water on the fields down there.
Right. Is it worth commenting on our response to the plan that nothing has changed substantively since the houses on the former scrapyard were built? And so the requirements for those we feel might be reasonably copied if this goes
well. I think it's worthwhile pointing out that those were raised specifically due to, and also the area of redevelopment on here on former Charlton site was limited to the existing built-up area on the grounds that it was a replacement rather than additional building. Because the site would have been large enough, so we've got a rather large development on there.
And also, sorry to harp on about it, the picture that we've got behind is in the documentation. There's the plan on Appendix 1, which has, and I know it's not the 12 that we're talking about, but it is an alternative version. And as we see there, there are three, I think, well, they call it two-person now, but they refer to it elsewhere as one-bed, two-person. Yeah. Yes. There are three one-bed, two-person. And I would like to say, if I could, that I'd rather have that version than the one with the larger houses, because it's a much more eclectic mix of housing.
Yes, and also there is if that's part of the affordable mix, there is a severe shortage of one-bedroom units.
Absolutely. Yes. Mike's talked about this previously as well.
To say that was the point I was going to raise about, are we happy with the mix of size of housing given the demand particular for starter homes in the area, and should we be making a recommendation about what we prefer to see in terms of size of house.
So would you be prepared to accept a higher density then? I mean, assuming that you want to support this application in principle, would you be prepared to see a higher density of sort of smaller units?
Yes, I think I would certainly, because that was when I first saw the ratio at the moment is 5 affordable, though are they a mix of sizes? It's 12... 5 out of 12 being affordable,
yes.
They
generally
are a mix of sizes.
I think we have to be careful about being too prescriptive, because do bear in mind it's an outline application.
Yeah.
It's not a full application. So when the full application comes in, that might be a more appropriate time to talk about housing mix. But if you wanted to suggest a higher number of smaller units, then this would be the time to do it, because the application at the moment is for up to 12 dwellings.
Yeah.
So if that is approved in outline,
that would be the upper limit.
Yeah. Well, I think certainly I'd like to suggest that. I don't know whether other people would support it, but I'd like, certainly like to.
Is the general support for that comment? Do I have a second one?
I'm suggesting going with this 13 bed version of their plan for own plan.
Right.
With 3 1 bedrooms.
David, I think you should phrase it your higher density.
Well, I'm just looking at the area.
That's 967. That there.
So what was that, 9?
Got the area of the plot again, Brian.
9,000.
Lunch. The aerial?
No, the area.
Yeah, it's outside the plot.
It's on there.
I just want to check densities, that's all. That's why I'm asking.
Yeah, on the one before. Yeah, 1.5 acres. On the one before that. Yeah.
Sorry, on this one?
Yeah, so yeah.
Okay, so total 967 square metres. 10,500 square feet.
I can't see how they can get that many houses on that little plot.
Well, so that's the point of your mind.
They're going to be very small houses. Mm-hmm. And where the castle are now?
Are they for the spaces? There's no way I think they've got a single parking space in front of them.
They've got two parking spaces, you can see, with small numbers in terms of all of them on this one.
Yeah.
Well, if it's
the alternative. Car parking is not. It's not obvious.
There's no car parking spaces. Is there?
No.
So where are they going to park?
So that's if the figure of
half. I say good or Andy T. Correct.
So they have.
It's going under roof. Can we have one meeting, please? We're just calculating densities here. Kevin's pulled up a figure here of 0.5 hectares for the area of the site, which gives a density of about 24 dwellings per hectare, which is quite low. I mean, normally you'll be looking at around 30 for a village age site. So if you wish to suggest increasing that by one, that brings it up to 26.
Trouble is, David, that's the road that takes up the area where you've got one now, so
yeah.
I still think I'd like to suggest you make a point
What I'm proposing to do is, first of all, to take a vote on whether we accept the principle of development on this site, mm-hmm. and then if that vote is in favour, then we'll move on to additional suggestions. So those who wish to support development on this site in principle, could you please indicate now, 1, 2, 3, 4, and those who would not, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
So what the objections are?
Surface water flooding.
It's bad as it is anyway.
Yeah.
Up the top of the common lane, nobody's mentioned there's a carriage at 150 yards down there. Henry's the weather people, but they use all that entrance.
Oh, yes.
Because otherwise they've got to come down beside Kaz Restaurant, which is only very narrow,
yes.
And the lorries are too wide to go down there. So they all use on the main.
Anyway, the...
So
this application is not supported.
Highways, flooding, sewage, surface water flooding.
Yes,
okay. Safety of the other houses.
Yes.
Well, the same way down there,
if you want to mention that specifically, I don't know.
Well, after jumps will have to be, because it's a bit too active and
non-existent. Yeah, it is, isn't it?
Well, they did put a mini roundabout at the top of the High Street there, didn't they? At the top of Common Lane. Mm. Yeah, that didn't last.
Right, do not support.
Okay. So, over the page, we've got one more application which is there. It's a non-material grant and it is there for information. So, I think all we can do is to move that. Do you want any questions? So, are we happy to approve those? I just point out that there were two unscheduled items of expenditure during the summer period. One was the replacement or the enhancement of the fence barrier between Hutchins and Hardings and the Millennium Cops. And that was came forward as a matter of some urgency. So we had a meeting at South Cams towards the end of July, in which it became, individuals were gaining access to the Hutchins and Hardings site, climbing on the extensive scaffolding which had been put up there. And the fence was in a good condition, the gaps were easy for people to get in. And so on health and safety grounds, we had to authorise that work. And that is, which item just is that? Should be on this one. It's about 600 anyway, so 690 actually.
Travis Perkins from
Park. Yes, it is. That's it. Yes. Box code painting.
Oh, fencing.
I'll point out the work was done by Alan. He made an extremely good job of it and saved us quite a bit of money. So I thought the alternative would have been not far short of £1,000. So it was a good piece of work. He did it very luckily, did it before he went on holiday. So the work was completed in a week. And also, we proceeded with the gold enclosures on Norway. I haven't got an invoice. But I'll just point that out to be clear, because that was getting urgent at the start of the football season. And then the one on spices, which we wouldn't have an estimate for, is later on the agenda. Okay, so any further comments on the finances?
Those we accept.
Drive 7, yeah. All those in three, all those in fields. And we have donation request from the Chavez Trust. Yes. You should have had a copy of that and also a copy of our grants and donations policy. So all those in favour of that? And we also have donation requests from the Equal Primary School.
This is them that caught us before some years ago, didn't it? They did the work on the pool and then asked us for some money.
That was quite a long time ago.
I didn't like the way they did it.
No.
Is that last donation they had? I mean,
they
haven't got
us
because they did work, they did have some money, but they used it on the pool after. That's why I think.
The work had been done to the pool and then we found it.
that they'd ask that donation.
So that wasn't the last one, because the donation I had before, the work was done after.
Does it say what specifically this money is for?
Yes.
The back rack.
I remember. Yes.
Rather than the back shed.
Yeah. I think it is, yes. Yes, basically it's from shed into our cycle racks.
Yeah. This is a technical point, but on the grants and donations policy, it says under two, requests will not be considered from projects that replace funding by public sector bodies. Since this is a school, how does that...
How do you satisfy
fit?
That?
Yeah. How does that fit into that criteria?
Well, it's clearly, would be replacing, they say in their statement, that it's because the county council won't
pay. Yes. I mean, I'm afraid that's increasing situations.
It is. Yes.
So,
well, if we're going to adopt our own policy,
yes,
then we ought to reject it.
Yes,
sadly.
Do I have to get more and more of it?
Yeah, yes. We are.
Yeah. Yes. Do I have a second?
Oh, hold on.
Yes.
So, do not support because
it's contrary to our policy of subsidising county council or local authority.
Another public warning.
Yeah.
Then, sorry, who proposed that?
So, all in favour of that proposal?
Well, so 1, 2, 3, 4.
And those against?
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, we're all against it, but, you know.
Do you know? Yeah, so I think it's a weak problem, but.
But not doing it.
We're not doing it.
Anyway, well,
but we're pursuing that for a moment. If we have a policy,
yes, I agree entirely. So I'm suggesting that we review our policy.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Because of the policy, the way it's stated, is we're clearly punishing parents and children for something that's not their fault.
But that's not, it's not a question of fault, is it? I mean, the policy is there so that higher authorities, so the district, local, or county council, can't just say, oh, we're not paying it, we'll rely on the parish to pay for it instead.
I think if members are unhappy in that aspect of our policy,
we should review it.
Right, golden changes and spices.
Two thoughts.
We had a site meeting back down there, by the way, in early August, didn't we?
Yeah, because I said it last meeting.
The location is going to have to be on the Cambridge Road side.
Where the cricket
stop. Where the
cricket stop. Yes. And
that corner.
Yeah. So just so members are clear of what's actually being proposed there. Right, so we have two
crates. £10,378. It's quite big.
It's
not going on to a building. It's going to be. It's got to be
three sides. And also there has to be space. It has to be all four sides, and there has to be large enough space
for the goals.
So we've got 10,378 and 8,015. The 80. Oh, exactly the same.
Yes.
The cheaper version, the cheaper one, is actually the one that was agreed last for parish to do the other two.
Right. Okay. And that work's been completed now.
No, it's not been completed yet. But it's on. Yeah.
Okay.
I think the issue with this is which is a very big issue, is the health and safety aspect. So our hands are somewhat tied here.
And also the fact that damage has been done by the girls, which the girls will just be replaced, and you just be replacing those again and again and again.
Well, they're being
replaced. So it's the main issue.
Have we got the money in reserves?
We've got the money in reserves, but I want to keep an eye on reserves because we have had several quite, we have had two quite substantial items of expenditure, particularly with government closures.
So at this stage, before we spend anything, what have we got in reserve?
That's over and above the statutory reserve.
So can I ask a question? Just a reminder about the other two enclosures. Were they smaller because they were adjacent to a wall?
They're going on the side of the building. So
there were only three sides?
Yeah.
So what was the cost substantially less than all?
Yeah. Well, it wasn't. It's still...
Yes, I think it is. You have more gold or spice.
And there's more gold, so it's nice to be
big. It's quite a bit larger, actually.
It's about 6 times, isn't it?
And the adults and juniors as well. Yes.
I propose we accept the 8,050.
I mean, I think this needs to be done with some urgency.
With some urgency.
Because we've got the football season already.
They're
out, 3 weeks now, aren't they?
Otherwise, we're going to get more damage to the existing goal and more cost.
So I've had a proposal, and I'll second that.
Yeah.
So, yes. Roger. So, all those in favour?
Yep.
Thank you. Right. And I'll point out the clerk did attempt to give a estimate, but was unable to do so. It's very difficult to get people to attend to jobs like this. But as I said, it's not for a point of trial. So, office air conditioning service, this is a regular item, isn't it?
Every year, but
I
don't get too
quite.
I think
I've tried
four different companies and then you have
to... Again, we've had to get into the beginning of the closing. We have one quote for 165 and the other for 156. And those are
both good. Yeah.
Just one of those, the local company have cops.
They're one of the ones that haven't applied, no.
So, do I have the third one?
156.
Yeah,
I'll second it.
Okay. All those in favour?
How many is that for? Two services here or one?
Let's just say service.
Right, so that can be unanimous, okay?
Air conditioning, does it heat and
Because
normally you get two, wouldn't you? You get one for the winter and then one for the summer. So
it's
to
heat.
We always have it serviced in sort of October.
Yes. Okay. Right, so if we move on to agenda item 95, which is the request for a dinner outside the Star Shop in the High Street.
It's
DC Suites. No, DC Suites isn't there anymore.
No, it's gone. Team of the Hearts.
Yes.
So who's the request for?
If we will install the bin outside or replace.
Is it going to be on the footpath where you're proposing it? Or is it going to be
near the outpost?
Yes. And they will donate
150.
Is
it they that requested it?
The people from
the spa owners. Can I clarify what Neil just asked? Is it going to be on the pavement or on their bit of the
on their frontage?
On their frontage.
Right. Before you go, there's discrepancy over the frontage. What nobody knows at the moment is actually being dealt legally. Through legal channels over the discrepancy of that frontage, because there is concerns from their side that it actually belongs to a council.
I'd always assumed that their area was where the service changes.
Yes, it would follow the line from the Mondo's house next door.
That's right. Yes.
It certainly looks that way. The reason I was interested is they put a sign on there which partially...
We have had the enforcement officer out about that. Because
you can see the road.
Yes, we can find that out.
The bridge would be smaller, but it would still obscure
It's not a fixed structure, which is part of it.
Right, okay.
It's just a concrete base which can be moved with some difficulty, I think.
Is the front an area that we litter pick?
No.
But apparently it has now been disputed.
Yeah, the point is, that's the same with Woodhouse Publishing. Boundary of that is right up there. But that's the same with the Jade, that boundary is right up to the farm.
It's under dispute at the moment.
Yeah, but I can't say I can be. Right. When the Proud Boys were there, they built them back.
Don't know is if there was any changes made in the deeds or anything like that.
Yes. I don't think it's quite as straightforward as that, Roger.
No, but I'm just saying, that's where the original building.
That was, as I said, that was always my assumption, because there was a clear change in the surface. Robert.
Neil's idea.
But there are pins along there, but I can't remember where. I thought there are building pins.
Okay. Right. If it's a movable item, what's the total cost, roughly?
Since it's not movable, the bin would be fixed. Would have to be fixed.
Yeah.
To a concrete bin.
I was talking about the sign that you were commenting on.
So until we establish who owns the land,
and we don't know where the services
are. I think also clarification. Who is actually going to enter?
Depends when we find out your own
views. Well, the recurring problem there is they don't permanently have a pay bin. They've had one. It's been fallen into disrepair. It's very quickly full. So then people just throw the rubbish on the floor. They don't clear it very regularly. The leaves collect there. All the rubbish. So it's very unsightly.
Yes.
Most of the time.
The issue was because it was put through a window. They removed the bin for safety reasons. It was not a case of the bin being in disrepair. Mm. It's because some idiot put it through the bit.
But it was in disrepair at times.
Well, no, that's not the reason it was removed.
No, sure.
So you can't use that as an argument. No, it wasn't the reason.
It was an observation rather than
Other issue is with it. And I actually agree with you on this point. The argument is that the area is not kept clean, but their argument is it's not their area.
So Neil's proposal is deferred. Do I have a second of a deferral?
Yeah, I've got a second.
Okay. So all those in favour of deferral to establish the ownership of the land.
Okay. And one member? Yeah.
No vote, because I don't.
Well, who, when you hear, who's in with district then?
Second.
Is it in like dispute with district? Or
no, it's a dispute with all councils.
Oh, right, so we would so then you ask like what's
which council actually owns it.
Yeah. Yes. So if I tell him that and then ask him to let me know when he's
done it.
Or themselves, yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
Right, yep. So moving on to agenda item 96, removal of BT phone boxes in the village, and BT, as you'll be aware, carry out our regular reviews of phone boxes.
Is this all phone boxes?
No, it's two.
It's two.
It's
two.
It's
two.
It's
two. It's two. It's two. It's two. It's two. It's two. It's two. It's
two. It's two. It's two. It's
two. It's two. It's two.
It's two. It's two. It's two. It's two. It's
I point out the two kiosks we're discussing today are the modern type. They aren't the old red ones, which are.
Do you have any
sort
of printables?
Yes,
it's a Chevrolet, don't
we? Do, yes.
I noticed something in the correspondence about adopting a phone box.
We have.
So adopted one at London Rye, but it's. We need to do.
Well, which, yes, which
moving
we
moving it to Chavis Drive, yes. And getting quotes for.
It is quite expensive to move them.
It's not actually that Alan do.
Because they're well secured.
Yeah, well secured. And
it's
also, also, you have to make good as well. They don't, you know, they can't be locked.
Yeah.
Yeah, so.
Sawston Parish Council. Purchased one, decided to donate it to the local primary school.
Yes.
It cost them over £2,000.
Yes,
they're
well into four figures. We don't have a definite quote yet.
But I will get quotes.
That's the sort of ballpark that we've been talking about. Yes, yeah, so.
Sorry, can I just ask a question then about this proposal or suggestion?
At the moment, there's a consultation closed on 10th of October asking whether we have any views on the removal of these.
Yes.
The one in Evans Way, I think, has one. Was that one?
That's one.
The one which was around the Mainbridge Way around it, and the other had nine.
Yeah.
And this is in the course of a year.
I mean, quite frankly, they are hardly redundant, aren't they?
Well,
I can't see why we would have a particular objection.
It's quite difficult to make the argument, but if members feel that there is a case for retaining them for emergency purposes... Or
if those two went, how would we be left within the village working?
One.
Who's that? The one top church lane?
Up from Mike. This is...
We should certainly keep one working for people who don't have a phone 24 hours in emergency in the village. We should certainly keep
that one. Is there one up from Y in that junction, that new road at the top there? Is
no,
there
I think that's a big one. Yeah, it's a big one.
I understand your sentiments in wanting to leave, but the possibility of the person that is unlikely to have a phone is probably the least likely to be able to walk any substantive distance to a phone box.
Even if they know where it is.
Even if they know where it is. I mean, I just feel largely public phone boxes or public phones
are in the box.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yes.
Good
yes,
ATMs and Wi-Fi hotspots though, but that's not a suggestion for this.
So the question is, do we want to make any representations in the course of this consultation?
I propose letting BT take them away.
Second one. Who said... Right, hold on. Remove both. Okay, vote. 4-1-10.
Which item? Against. Against. Oh, sorry.
No,
two. Except.
Yeah,
the
second one.
Thank you. Right, so agenda item 97. Oh, yes. This is on the agenda.
in the request of Beck Laxton, who, if you recall at the last meeting, suggested that that when people are nominated chair or vice chair of committees, presumably, this is to explain how long they've been on the PC and what qualifications they have. You know, it's a, that we want people to present a CV. It's entirely up to you, I guess.
Well, it says present a CV, but I don't think she was wanting to be as specific as, you know, the life and times of relevant experience.
Couple of minutes chat, or just say, I am X and I have done 1, 2, 3, therefore.
Yeah.
That seems reasonable.
But that you, no, I'm afraid you'd only do it once, then.
Well, you don't
every, you're going to do the committees every year, you know.
The thing is, this is like with the floodgates, you have to do it every single year, you don't have to justify it.
Write a personal statement, and then the personal statement is...
You do that when you become a councillor.
What you're saying, other than what you're saying, Bob, is already in place, so what's the point of making...
It's something that's already there, duplicating yourself.
Sorry, which way? I misunderstood.
You would make a statement of what qualifications you've got in your declarations so that you can see what your qualifications are.
I don't think I've put any qualifications or anything to do with CV.
So, what declarations of interest did you put down? Your business?
Yeah.
Well, no, I think we're talking about two different things, actually.
Possibly.
In order to stand for the council to be elected, all you need is your name on a nomination sheet. And a brief description of yourself, which I think is up to 5 words you can use if you wish to use it.
I think what
Kevin is talking about is the declaration of interest form, which you're required to fill in, which is quite extensive
but could be empty.
Well, only if you're rough sleeper without
I genuinely don't remember putting anything that would have been relevant to
business.
For example, there's the HR committee, which we apparently appoint automatically, although I can't see anything in standing orders.
Sure.
Can I just ask you a point of information then from the clerk to tell me where? Because I've searched through it and can't find any related anything. I've done the search. But on that base, for example, obviously Janet's doing that because you're the chair of planning. But if she wasn't, she should have been anyway, in my view, because she's got the HR experience. And so do I, but I haven't written that down. You wouldn't know that unless I told you that over 25 years I employed 200 and something people.
Yeah. Yes.
And interviewed.
Well, I think yes. I think part of the problem with this is that in terms of council experience, this could actually have the opposite effect to the one that she wanted to achieve, because the people who are going to be most experienced are the ones who've been doing it for the longest time.
That's right. But she also objected to formation of the chairman, because she wanted the Osmar from hers to be the chairman. But you won it fair and square.
Yeah. I mean, it was a very difficult situation, not one which I want to...
It was an uncomfortable situation.
The procedure was quite correct.
The procedure we followed.
So, basically, do we want to adopt this recommendation or not?
This
question before us.
A view of what would actually be, whether it's standing up and saying, my name's Joe Boggs and I have this experience, or the personal statement, which we had a brief confusion about. So
that's not clear, actually, from what was proposed, is it?
No. Was that, sorry?
It's a pity that you're not here, actually. Mm.
And defer it until another occasion is
over. Plus, yeah.
Yes.
Actually, that's.
I think that's fair because you know, I'm not, you know, like you, I'm not entirely clear what she actually had in mind there.
So that's.
I think what Bex was on about is when so I got voted onto the council, and the first meeting I had to vote on council who was chair and vice chair.
Yeah.
But I didn't know anything about anybody.
But now you do it for next time.
I was sort of seeing blind almost.
I mean, with Bex and Kieran living at the same house, they've already got two votes.
But that's not really the point. The point is, under the situation Colin describes, and I was in the same place, there was no written proposal about why the people who were nominated and voted on were standing. It might have been very blindingly obvious, but there was nothing beforehand to give us any indication of who might be sat, who the candidates were, or what their experience was, or anything else. So
you don't have to do war or peace,
So if we have a vote on deferral, those in favour of deferral.
Can I have vote once, Mike?
So that's deferred. Discussion is closed.
He was told.
Right, replacement seats. Replacement seats and bins. I saw you going past.
Did you?
Yes, that's a weird old watch. We should put the agenda famous through our little box.
So obviously we budgeted last year to replace bins and seats within the village, so I went round with Alan last week and we've come up with a list. Mm-hmm. 14 of the range of litter bins that we've already got to replace the open bins that are dotted around, a seat and four dog bins. So the cost of all the products is £7,356, but then we need to get the slabs which go under the benches and the bins, so which would be an extra 100. So it would be about £7,500. Right. We budgeted 9 for under planning and recreation, but then we've gone around that literally is going to do all the bins. We've done all the recreation rounds last time, and this is the estates. I have a list, but I couldn't tell you. Not new ones, replacing all the open bins.
I thought it came up that they just needed normal place bins, they didn't need dog bins because they
There are some areas that do need dog bins. Replacing dog bins that are already there.
I think, yes, I mean, that's correct, because I think there's an issue with the open ones, whereas
So we have budgeted for them, so I'm going to get them in because then this is a winter job for you and put them all in, so we're within budget.
Alison's proposal accepted. Do I have a second one?
Yeah.
Okay. So if there's any further discussion, all those in favour of them?
Yeah.
Okay. That's unanimous. Not aware of scraping, can you ask me that?
Yes. It's gone by the 10th of October.
Yes, this is an annual exercise, isn't it? So I remember doing one of these not that long ago, actually. I did one about this time last year. Basically, it's a question of identifying areas in the village which we are aware from local knowledge are subject to flooding, but which the county is apparently not. And this also includes surface water flooding, doesn't it?
Does it nominate or does it involve a throne and sitting there and commanding the water to recede?
No, which you may if you wish.
It's identifying any areas which sites on dry land. It is
important because this feeds into issues, new developments and
remedies, and you know, what needs to be inadequate and soap ways and so on. So, I mean, for example, there's a regular surface water problem, for example, at the junction of Dale Road Holmway, which is, we have heavy rain, and
Holmway and Sutton.
Yes.
Do we have an emergency plan?
We don't actually, and I think that's probably something that which we need to think about.
All you do is call for help.
That's pretty much an emergency.
Yes, we are, parish councils are recommended actually to produce emergency plans, but they're fairly lightweight. It's really just a question of knowing where to go, for example. I mean, if you basically, who are the key holders, say, of the various public buildings, should you need to accommodate people who have to be evacuated from houses or whatever?
Okay.
So, you know, where anybody in the village who has items of specialised equipment which may be useful for.
That sounds perfectly reasonable. The reason I would, for my cynical comment, was that yes. It's suggesting, you know, creating action plans and
pointing flood marshals.
Community resilience to flood risk. I'm not quite sure about the tone of this
to accommodate the emergency plan that Rob was talking about is a different angle to this, because you're talking about any type of emergency.
Yes, you know, and it would also cover flood as well.
High winds and tree blocking the way out of the bush or something like that.
But there are some quite significant areas in the bottom of the hill as you come from.
Oh yes, there is. Yes, I know.
Floods regularly.
Yeah, sure.
It does. It does. There's the area of the bush that you can find. That's probably out of the village. There's
a village. It doesn't look like,
does
it?
It's
not
looking
today, is it?
You see it more than I do.
Evans Way floods.
Yes, yes.
Bottom of Westmore Avenue floods. Right. I've seen it nearly going in
the house.
But
there are issues as well about maintenance of roads and drains, etc. Because one of the issues in, you know, St Mary's Road and other roads is when there is heavy rainfall, you do get water running down the curbside simply because they're not clear. They're all full of weeds at the moment.
That's not that the drains are full up, it's just the soakaways are full up as well.
Yeah,
well, in over 52 years of Westmore Avenue, rain and dirt going down.
You can't clean
the soakaways out because it goes into a drain.
Yeah,
right. They're a bit concrete.
Okay.
Yeah. So on this, like, does your parish have any flood risk that you're aware of? I put Hackridge Hill or farm entrance.
Yes.
Where did you say?
There's a difference between what
line
Roger is referring to now, which is running water off, for example, tarmac or concreted surfaces.
Yes.
So there's an increasing problem of people paving their gardens, and that increases the problem with runaway water.
Yeah, but like that down Westmore Avenue, it's not because people have done the driveways, it's because the rain's so. And there's a long way down there.
No, but I assure you, it has a significant impact. In fact, in several parts of the world and the country, they're banning people from paving their gardens because of this issue.
Well, yes, I mean, there was a change in building control regulations about 3 or 4 years ago relating to the porosity of half surfaces.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
There's a thing called subs that for example, if you replace your drive now, sustainable urban drainage system.
Well,
you have to make sure that the water will soak into the drive rather than run off it.
Subs usually relate to new developments and having the surface water. That's slightly different.
Another impact of this though is also the fact that with developments a lot of soakaways are being taken away and built on. And I totally agree with what you're saying as well, Brian, but it's also developments in that like where I live in Dale Way, they put housing on what was traditionally soakaways. So, agree with him totally, but it's an even bigger impact with it.
There's also up at the village college by the sports centre. I know that's their land, but it gets quite bad in when you've got heavy rainfall. It's right next to the swimming pool. Yes, I've often thought it's a health hazard.
There's an issue of water retention in the high street, because when the 20 mile an hour limit was put on, if you recall, there were traffic calming arms. They're actually quite mild ones, but they are there if you look at them. And those were not actually that well installed, because they do tend to retain
the water.
That's part of the problem.
Something's happened to halfway down to the building program.
Yes.
How recently was Mill Lane flooded?
Yes.
How recently was Mill Lane flooded?
Often when the sewer gets full out, when the sewer comes out.
I was just asking.
You had one last year.
I've seen that.
2002.
Would your parish be interested in setting up a community flood action group?
Yeah, what do you want to do? March, don't do it.
You get a pair of wheels, an awful lot of paper towels actually.
Yes.
Do you see the sheep can swim?
The trouble with souls is the environmental agency.
Yes. Yes. Thank you. Anyone else?
Okay.
Would you be interested in organising a meeting to discuss the potential community flood action group? So I guess, yes, it would be then people, wouldn't it? Yeah, that would be quite useful. It would be helpful for planning applications as well.
But it don't take notice, it's still good.
No.
Won't take notice?
No, they don't take any notice.
It might be a notice.
Right, thank you. Okay, so we'll show interest.
Right, so if we can move on to the correspondence, we have a thank you card from Gina.
That's nice.
I'll pass around. A very big thank you to all the councillors who gave to my retirement fund. It's very much appreciated, and I'd like to take this opportunity to say that I enjoyed all my 16 years at the parish council as you know. And I'll pass that around if you want to come
Right,
so update by county councillor.
Right, I did send a report to Joe this afternoon. It's quite long. It covered four issues. I want to talk about two of them.
I'll
email
it to everyone tomorrow, but I'll get it.
Right, the first thing is that the local government planning commission for England announced, I think on the 5th or 6th of September, its final decision on county council division boundaries for the 2017 elections. And it confirmed, as far as we're concerned, what its previous stance was, and that is the existing Sawston division is seven villages with two members. The seven villages are Great Shelford, Carston, Hawkston, Little Shelford, Newton, Sawston, and Stapleford. Mm. And because the county is contracting from 69 to 61 members, and the figures are based on populations in 2019-2020, it means that each person will represent more electorates than at present. Yeah. And the change is to retain all seven villages within the same electoral division, rename Sawston and Stapleford, and to add on to it, Bayburn and Hazenfield.
Yes. So it's based on numbers of electors, isn't it? Not right, population.
And the whole project was to even out the number of electors per division. Stapleford
is the name of
it. Yes, Stapleford is included in it.
Yeah.
It is.
So that's the first thing. The second thing is, the parish council should have received notification about the county council's local highway schemes bid process for 2017-18, and bids have to be made by the 30th of November. So there's quite a lengthy time.
And, they'll be on the next planning agenda in September.
Okay, and so just tell you that the panel will be meeting on the 30th and 31st of January to assess each of those schemes. So that, those are the first two things. The third thing is about the city deal. In the minutes of the parish council meeting on the 26th of July, on some 76 on the minutes, we did talk about a city deal tackling peak time congestion in Cambridge. And this is going to be discussed in the next planning meeting on the 27th of September. And just to remind you that the closing date for responses is Monday, the 10th of October. Yes, so yes. The parish council needs to get a response in. This is an important issue for access to Cambridge, but any individual can actually respond as well. So that's the 10th of October. But,
and any business that you may have said maybe of that.
That's right,
yeah.
The fourth thing is about devolution and just an update on devolution. I did refer to it quite extensively in July, but we did discuss it at that meeting. We came to a decision. Of you to put forward. Now, basically, in addition to all response from parish councils, businesses, etc., there's been an online survey, and there was a survey carried out by Ipsos Mori. All that information is now being collected. The Ipsos Mori poll was published quite recently, and councils, all the seven councils involved, will be meeting, having special meetings towards the end of October to discuss their final views in relation to the devolution package. The county council's meeting is on Wednesday the 25th of October, and in fact the district council meeting on Thursday the 26th of October. So all the councils will be meeting about that. So those in a sense are some general issues. I just wanted to read you a couple of emails now, one of which relates to Mike's favourite topic, Buckridge Hill. This is the latest from Brian Heffernan. We've only very recently received the results of the drainage survey that was carried out by Highways contractors. I'm scheduled to meet the relevant Highways officers later this week at the site to consider the next steps. I will advise you of the outcome of the meeting. So,
who's coming?
That's Brian Heffernan, who's a senior officer for flood risk. I don't know. Do you think it might be relevant if I respond to say you'd like to go? Or a parish council representative?
While we're on Buckridge Hill, in the paper there's an update on or an upgrading of cycleways.
Yeah.
Now, is our cycleway on it?
I'm not sure.
Well, can you find out? Because that needs something doing to
it. We've agreed on that.
And also, they was on about the cycleway from Stapleford along the bypass. Now, that will not benefit Sawston College.
Not agreed, yeah. Yeah, no, I completely agree about the need. I mean, it was a very early cycleway, but it's just not built to modern standards.
I mean, the one that's built in Roman times, wasn't it?
No, you meant Australia then.
Right, so anyway, that was an update on Buckridge Hill. The next one is an update on the source of another. I'd like to read this one to you. This is an update from Martin Marsh, who's the project manager. She says, we're still finalising the license agreement for the construction compound that needs to be signed off by the County Council and Sawston Parish Council. Our solicitors were sent the agreement last week with a couple of amendments that are being revised. The planning application is ready for submission, but we need to wait till the license agreement has been signed off by both parties. We anticipate the planning application will be submitted by the end of September.
Well, I just point out that I signed that off in the end of June.
No, because the actual ask agreement's gone through to the solicitors. Because I was going to sign it, and the solicitor said, don't sign what I had. She's going to send all the paperwork for me to sign, so I've not signed it yet, but we will.
So
it will, because there was... Well, it wasn't the final one, but yeah, we've got, I'm waiting for that.
So we're almost there as far as that's
concerned. Yes, yes.
Okay. So those are two emails I wanted to be sent to you. And the other thing was about the donations that we made to the parish council. We saw the list tonight. And I just wanted to bring your attention to the donation to the summer reading challenge of £150, which you very kindly agreed to.
Yes, yeah.
Just to tell you that the summer reading challenge presentations are Saturday at the library.
All right.
So I'm doing a presentation and I'll be very happy to say I think it's 10 o'clock.
Okay.
I shall be happy to say a few positive words about the support of the parish.
Okay.
What about the crossing? Any more on the crossing, please?
I mentioned that to Joe just before the meeting started. I haven't heard from Sharon about the proper cost, so we need to check some sort of
time. Well, it was approved in January, which was supposed to be done. So it is quite a lot.
No, they didn't agree the year.
Yeah. And they haven't filled the road, they haven't filled the potholes, they haven't done anything, and it's just as bad driving down there as it was before they've done it.
Well,
so it's only chance they can have a good call us there as well and have a thorough inspection.
They did do some patching the end of autumn, before the summer, before the winter, it's certainly not good enough by any means. I mean, you've got to fit all the trenches going across.
So have you
every time you go over, Yeah.
Has that been paid for? Because I would actually question that, if that's been paid for, because that is extremely substandard.
It is substandard.
Well, I'm happy to arrange a meeting with our road officers.
Yeah, definitely.
The other thing also I think Joe's raised is the quality of the lining.
Some of them are straight.
But with regard to the face,
Well, it's I mean it's not only that, it's also the renewal.
It's the faded ones, like the ones that are on the crossing at the health centre. But they're going to come out and look at the areas, but they will only repaint the ones that are faded badly.
Because I reported a pothole at the top of Link Road, which was done fairly promptly, but it was in the middle of one of the roundhills, and it was just left as a black tarmac surface. And there was no attempt to replace the paintings on the road. And
that
only has to happen a few times, and the thing's completely disappeared.
There are instances, this it doesn't throw the change up in a very good point, but where 30 mile an hour rounds have been repaired. So you lost them, no. Yeah. Wouldn't change the But if we go sign a meeting with the Bay couple the white line with them.
Sorry. Mr. Chairman, on the side of it, there's no use coming on a sunny day. You want to come there when it's wet.
Yeah.
For the simple reason, all those seams, so that's the seam of the trenches, there's water penetrating in there nearly an inch deep. And when that freezes, all the tarmac's going to be gone.
Yeah.
And that's all the way to sand, all the way to length of Bain Road that they resurface.
Okay.
And every crossing, where they dug across the road, where the sewerage went too long.
Okay, that's half a comment.
It does seem as if tarmacking nowadays, it does seem to be finished several inches before the curbside. That's certainly the case if you go down St Mary's Road. I mean, you're about 6 inches in from the curb. It's just soil, it's not tarmac.
They've got to have water going somewhere.
Yeah, I suppose so. But the issue is that it does let frosting, and then the damage to the tarmac across the road as a whole.
Yes, I mean, I think it's fair to observe that we've had three very mild winters without significant hard frosts, and If we have a hard winter, I think the problems will start to open up a bit. But anyway, that's just
Kevin, what Mike said. If you've got the water penetration
When they did Mill Lane, and I queried why they were doing it, because clearly it's partially cosmetic, but the prime purpose of doing that is to seal off the surface so that you don't get water penetration. Yes. So if it's not done properly, then it's absolutely redundant. Yeah. And I mean, it certainly doesn't improve the ride of the, along the road, as I've already said, because the underlying structure is so poor.
Right, so thank you for the update, and the printed version will be circulated tomorrow. Moving on to councillors' issues and agenda items for the next meeting. I have one piece of correspondence we have here, which is from Network Rail. We want to carry out track inspections on the Spices level crossing between 0050 and 4:30 on the 23rd of November. And for that purpose, then we'll need to close the entrance to Spices. I don't think it's that well used at the 4 hours of the morning, but anyway, they've asked for our approval to proceed. I don't think it made much difference if we refused it, but I just really announced that for information.
Thank you.
He's looking at the business project.
Yes, I've got quite a lot to say, I'm afraid. So Sawston Parish Council meeting on the 12th of the 4/16. These cameras. It's better enough to report the council meeting, but it's the comments that go with it on Facebook. First one was the council is white, middle class, privileged males. Now I'd like to just wonder what that means. Another comment was, we've got two cameras now. We might as well be in Hollywood. What else have we got? Another person, relatively speaking, thinks it's probably and disappointingly quite accurate. What the hell are we doing? This is a parish council. This filming of these meetings isn't meant to have people's comments written all over them. What are we going to do about it? I think the letter should go to this bloke Pickles, explain what's happening here, and see what he says. Because it's making this parish council a load of lunatics.
Well, I mean, I think it's, I think, you know, whether you like it or loathe it, it's a product of social media and the age we live in.
It could well be, but I mean, things have happened to me that I could say about different things. We had the, protesters at Baber Hall and that, things like that. Now, I mean, I've got a few sheep. We count them quite regularly. The other week, There was 41 in the field. Weighed in the next week, there was 40. We've had sheep visit Sutton Walden. They've been arrested by police. They walked into Tesco car park. We've had sheep on the road at Shelford. The police do nothing. We can't accuse people for the simple reason if we said people's names or accused different people, if that's all on camera, we'd be hauled up in court.
Well, if you were to attempt to name somebody in a public meeting, whether there's a camera or not, I'm afraid I'd have to stop you because, you know, it's the same rules whether it's been filmed or not.
I appreciate that.
Tony Fell raised that at the last meeting. He was supposed to do something about.
Okay. Yes.
Tony
no.
Fell.
We're going to put it on the next meeting because we feel it should be said when Tony's here.
Fair enough.
So, it has to get mentioned.
But I felt like, you know, the people concerned, they know who they are, just to verify what they're saying.
Yeah. But I'm not sure there's a huge amount this parish council can actually do about that.
No, it should be, I mean, is it Eric Pickles who brought the law in the next week down? Well, he should know how things are going. Comments that people are adding on.
Well,
yeah.
His replacement should
know. Yes.
I mean, I don't know the simple reason. I haven't got a, what do you call it, laptop or anything like that. But people have told me.
Yes, yeah.
This is something where the digital engagement that we previously spoken about with an update to the website and possible ways for people to get in touch with council members could come in, and this is an exact prime example of where basically engaging a bit of customer relations. That's
do you think that's a good relations then when people make comments like
people
that?
People will always make comments like that. And if they don't say it on Facebook, they can say it the difference is that this is going to a lot of people, and what we want to do is make sure people realise we're trying to help out, we're volunteering to come along, give up some of our time, and make sure that basically stuff in Sawston is better for people in Sawston. They're better. There'll always be someone who will say, the verges haven't been cut, we don't have a wooden bus stop.
People and always make complaints, but they never come up with anything constructive and with ideas.
No, and that's...
Yeah, but that's how a lot of us, isn't it? I mean, that's the it goes with the territory.
Yeah.
And whether or not it's broadcast via video or it's just a public meeting where members of the public come along who could quite easily go away and make comments about the nature of the meeting, but that's our lot.
Yeah, well, the issue I have with it is, as you say, it's that lot, and being a district councillor, it's but one thing I don't like, and I'm a person that comes from an old world, and that's, if you've got something to say about me, tell me to my face. Hiding behind that and making a comment, that to me is not on. If you're prepared to make a statement, name who you are, so everybody knows who you are. Now, if you were down the pub, which is to say, that you'd make that statement, you'd have a face-to-face contact with the person that's making that statement. The thing I don't like about this is that there's people making comments under pseudonyms, which, if you want to make a comment, by all means, I have no problem with the comment. Name yourself.
Yes.
I have Tony in the gym.
I was going to say for some time people have come along to county council meetings and the other meetings, city deal meetings, and filmed them all the way through. And in a sense, people can tweet all sorts of things during the meeting. So sometimes, well before a meeting is finished, people they know what the decisions are, what the votes were, etc. You know, in a sense, that's that's part of trying to engage with the public, to tell people what's going on. And one of the problems with many councils, and that's the county, the district and parishes, is very few people actually come along and see us in action. The vast majority of people have never been and seen us actually in a parish council meeting.
And
how many people come on though? If we've got five people, it's a crowd.
And
actually, how many people know what we actually do, or even the sort of things that we discuss?
And I would say that we are better off having this broadcast so people can see that we're serious about the deliberations we make. And actually, I think, Mike, it's the video in here is a riposte for the complaints. Because if people bother to watch it, they can see that it's a serious matter that we take seriously and do our best.
Yes.
I'm afraid that's left me. I'm very, very aware of other councillors, what they're going to say behind my back. You lose trust. And trust is one of the best things to have in people. I may be old-fashioned, but you must have trust in people.
But surely this...
Janet.
Sorry, I was just going to bring the discussion back a bit, so I suppose, because I think, if I understand right, one of Mike's comments was about the issue of personal comments through Facebook or other media, and I'm not sure what we can do to prevent that. But the only thing I'd say is that in itself may discourage people from coming forward to want to take part in public life. There's an issue that's not been reported in the national press recently about how attacks on politicians through Twitter, etc., can be quite discouraging to people.
Yes.
And if we as a council, we would like, because one of your points was this issue of it being, of a bias towards one side or another. I don't actually agree with that, but I do think if it's a council we want to encourage people to participate, then we should try properly through the website in order to promote more what we do and try and also monitor where there are any instances of personal comments that we think are particularly unkind and need to be addressed.
Right.
I was just going to say that as far as trust is concerned, if we have the camera, then people can trust what we've said because it's verifiable. And if they do want to sit through hours of parish council, then they can see that we've made true and proper statements and that we've acted as we should and that everybody here is doing the utmost to just...
These things I've mentioned are council business that's been added to the council.
Yeah, but, sorry, Mike, a comment in public about the diversity or lack of it in the council is visible here. The fact is that it was largely accurate. I mean, I think Rob is, must reduce our average age by a substantial amount because he's in his 20s. So, we've got to be more robust than taking, a light-hearted, sceptical remark about the diversity of the council as it is formed. We've got to be better. We've got to be able to cope with that, surely.
I mean, I think going back to Tony's comment about it widening our audience, and I recall looking at the first video recording of the City Deal meeting. I think it had 49 hits in the space of 6 weeks. our online audience has greatly increased by videoing, but that's just an observation.
But sometimes things are posted on the do attract lots of hits.
Yes. Mm. So just one more comment, and I'll give a close discussion moves on, okay?
Yeah, the people on Cambridgeshire County Council, or people like yourself, you're all paid.
We're not.
Not a lot.
No.
The parish council are all volunteers to try and do the best they can for the residents of the village. That's the difference.
Yes. Yeah, but that doesn't mean that we're above criticism. So we can come to a wrong and inappropriate decision. No, we're not capable.
I mean, I think we're beginning to get around in circles. So I think that your points are noted, and I think we'll could we move on, Roger.
No. Yes. There's a biting church line opposite where the footpath comes out.
Yes.
It keeps on flickering on and off during the daylight and at night.
Yes.
Why? You walk your dog there, I walk mine.
You reported online.
Yes, it's
sorry?
Online.
Very lucky you must have seen it.
Yes.
But when you're looking at it, it doesn't do it.
Well, yeah, the dog wants to move on.
They've got window switches,
haven't
they? Yeah. And the other thing is, so it's actually the dog that's causing this electrical
thing. Yeah, it's not. We're on the side.
Okay.
Is there going to be a late night shopping? Because there's been no notification to youth groups and community groups.
Yes, there will be a late night shopping.
But
we haven't got a confirmation of the actual date. I'm assuming it will be November. Is it the 9th, the 2nd?
The second Friday.
Yeah, so it's a case. I will chase that up and find out exactly what's going on. I know Beck is dead keen on getting it going. So it's a case of seeing what input that Emma Jaw's put in from last year, the last 2 years. But she did. I spoke to her earlier on this year. She said she was keen to do it. So the answer is yes, but I don't know when.
Okay.
Are road signs our concern?
They're district.
Okay.
Street names are district. Road signs are
county. Oh, yeah, it's a district one. Yeah. Okay.
Yeah, that's a district one.
In that case, I don't have anything to comment on.
Good.
Right. Just quickly, the Barclays site, I saw at the actual meeting, there was some comments about the banner that advert
yes,
that's been put
yes,
up,
yes,
and I wondered whether we've actually asked...
Having spoken to Sainsbury's
right. To actually speak to the guys there, because obviously that sets a precedent if it's left there.
We've got enforcement on that, and it's advertising for the job place when it's actually legal.
It's not illegal, you have to have the banning permission.
Yes.
Oh, okay, yes. Fine.
Yeah.
But in any case, it's a Sainsbury's issue as well, isn't it?
It is, yes.
I posted some complaints on the district council website, I think it was about litter along the 505.
Yes, yes.
You know, the lay-bys, and actually they did come along and empty the bins along there, but I've noticed that they're full and overflowing again, so I don't know what the regularity of clearing is.
Yeah,
I know it's not within our boundaries, but it's something that affects people so going outside the litter.
Thank you.
No, nothing more to add.
Yeah, thank you.
I was going to ask about street lamps, but you just said good. All I wanted to say.
Street lamp road, street lamp
town.
No, hold on.
No, okay. In that case...
No, I've got a list. Don't worry, I've got anything to say. Right. Firstly, the D-bits are now... at Linton Way Mill Lane. They've been installed, the machines have been there, but I'm just waiting for the ambulance people to confirm they've got it on their system before we make them live. So, they're up and running.
Yeah,
okay. Tony, I was going to ask about the weeds along all the curbs and everything, because we're getting a lot of complaints about them.
Yes.
And we've taken over the verges because you won't do them. But now that, it just is looking...
Yeah. I think it's Jonathan Clark, but I can check the name.
If you can let me know, because we need to, quite a few complaints. Well, just very unsolidary.
Well, the weeds that are coming up between the curb and the road, I think are South Cam's responsibility. And they do need another... They do
they're not spraying as much. I think Mike Cooper, I remember him saying they're not coming out to spray as often as they did cutbacks together.
That's
that.
Yeah,
so is that
part of
the district council?
I think so, yes.
Is that even down Church Lane?
Everywhere.
Is that about 2 foot tall?
Yes.
Yeah, that's
right. They're all.
Everywhere.
Aren't they?
Yeah.
In fact, I think some bells
aren't
the other
way. Can I just follow on for that? Can we have an agenda, one of the things, I don't know, or mind which one, about the suggestion that we actually take full control, vis-a-vis the conversation we had about subsidiarity, for all grass cutting.
Yes,
and actually have a proposal or a discussion about the alternatives available to us to take the money from the county and the district and take control of it all, as was suggested by Ian in that training that we did.
Yes, I mean, I think it's...
It would be quite a project if we could have a conversation about it.
Yes, I mean, I think we need to look at options on that. I agree. I'm not sure we necessarily go down that route, but I think...
No, but
be considered.
I haven't finished.
Okay.
Sorry. I was just getting everything in while I've got it. So just let you know that our annual return signed and back, everything's fine, no matters arising from that. So we're all done and signed off. And my last thing is, I don't know if we have an issue at Spices, but over the last few months, I've had to get the electrician out because lights are going, sensors are going, there's been quite a lot of things happening up there. The electrician went out this weekend because I had a call from the cricket club saying one of the sockets had blown. He's actually brought it in because it's just burning and it's all melted on the inside. He also checked in the entrance hall because one of the lights wasn't working and the wiring, it's not been wired correctly. I am slightly concerned about it because obviously this was in the bar and there's only myself and the sports clubs that have access to the bar, so if that had been left.
Well, I mean, if there's a confusion between the earth and the lump.
So they have neutral in the live and live wired up to neutral.
So who actually wired this thing up?
Well, this was obviously.
Yes.
Yeah. So obviously, when the builder, the builder obviously got his electrician in, all these things happening. I just want your advice on should we have an electrical survey?
I think we
should. It's astonishing that it would have passed a test for not being used.
I mean, I find
that. I know you have to test in.
Yeah,
but you have to test every.
Because I find that quite extraordinary.
The other thing is, I did say that we should really have an electrical test every 5 years on ours. So, shall I get quotes to do
all the we can't spend any money under this
budgeting,
but on the other hand, there is such a thing as chairman's action.
Yes.
So I think we need to get on this really urgent
chairman's action.
So do you want me to get Spices done regardless?
Because
I'm thinking that this is why everything keeps going wrong, because there's obviously something.
There's not the potential for a fire.
If it's wired up incorrectly, I think you need to. It's not only explains what's happening.
It's just unfortunate because I'm not going to call it.
I think potentially we need to close the building, I'm afraid, until it's actually sorted. Because, if earth neutral and live mixed up, then you're potentially got live surface equipment.
Start with
it.
I should be able to get it done.
Yes. I mean, I think, try and get something done as quickly as possible.
Immediately. So go with Spices and then we need to, I'll get quotes or ask him as well, whoever. Because obviously we need to get into
or if you don't close the building, at least take over the socket. So.
The other issue is that's looking like that could be potentially a faulty fuse.
No, it's the wire. He's taking it. He's actually,
That's your neutral one, I suppose. That's actually
right. Yes.
Yes. And that means your power is
going down
in neutral somewhere.
Yes, well, that was what.
Okay.
Do you know what I mean? And your neutral is loose.
Anyway, I'll get them to come out and do a
little Brian, can we, in this matter, can we check and get recourse on the builder and or his electrical contractor if it's shown that there's faults in the fault?
I was going to say, it's when I started, yes. So it's about 9.
There will be a sign-off after the building was completed by an electrician.
Yes.
And the fact is, we would, I'm sure, have legal records if it's shown that wiring is now faulty, yes. Or was always faulty.
Well, has there been wiring work done in there since? Because I was surprised if it's that bad. It was only just beginning to show up.
Yeah. Well, we did have the sensors, didn't we?
But that wouldn't... That
no.
That's not bad. Oh, we haven't practiced over a year.
But it,
yeah, the yes. Protection. You should put one into your plugs, and that will tell you if you've got live neutral or no.
Well, I don't know what's happening, but it's definitely something happening up there.
Cause yeah, certainly because the wire is getting loose in there. We've got to put in right most likely. They all got one chip.
Okay, right, I'll finish the meeting then. 9:17.